Okay, hello everybody. Thanks for being here. We're going to present an alternative CI/CD workflow that we worked on for Fedora packaging. And from there, we'll start a discussion with you to see what we can do to improve and continue from there. So I am Mathieu Huin, this is Fabien Boucher. We are engineers at Red Hat, and basically we live and breathe Zool there because we contribute to the Zool project upstream. We contribute code. We maintain instances for Red Hat for other projects there. And we also help people get bootstrapped with Zool. So now you might have a question about what Zool actually, because you might have not heard about it, because it's a relatively new player in the CI/CD ecosystem. But it's gaining a lot of traction because it has lots of very good features. And actually, talking about those features would take a whole different presentation. So we're just going to focus on the features that are really interesting for us right now. So basically, Zool is a CI/CD system that was developed by and for the OpenStack community. And it is well adapted to the pull request workflow. So first, because it supports code review systems that implement the pull request workflow or something similar, such as Gerrit, GitHub, Pagure, and soon GitLab. And also, it is event-based, so that means that it's going to trigger job and builds for different events during the life cycle of a pull request. So that is especially interesting for testing pre-merge and post-merge. And also, it is natively able to make cross-repository testing. So that means that you can test ahead of time before pull requests are merged. So you can test all of them, those pull requests together without having to merge them beforehand. So that's also interesting for a packaging workflow because packages are interdependent. And finally, another interesting feature is the fact that Zool has an approach, has a CI as code approach. And by that, I mean that jobs and configuration are written in YAML, so it's pretty simple and straightforward to understand. And the jobs in particular are written in Ansible. Those are Ansible playbooks. So that means that while it's easy to maintain, it's easy to version and to develop. And also you have access to the whole Ansible ecosystem for your jobs and your tests. So all those features make Zool quite a good candidate for RPM packaging, testing, and CD on that. And actually we talk, it's not out of nowhere, we talk from experience because we have implemented not one but twice RPM packaging workflows with Zool. So we did it once with the RDO community, so to package OpenStack for CentOS. And we did it also for ourselves for the project Software Factory, which is packaging productivity tools like Zool actually and other things for CentOS as well. So we know what we're talking about because we've done it twice. And we were thinking of doing maybe doing it three times for Fedora because there's no reason why we shouldn't share the goods with other fine people of Fedora. So the idea would be the benefits for Fedora would be first a more familiar pull request based workflow for newcomers because most open source contributors are used to this workflow. So that would help, that would make the entry cost less steep for newcomers. Also, it would open more possibilities for automation at every step of the pull request lifecycle, because as I said, Zool is events-based and reacts to events on the pull request lifecycle. Also, even if more experienced packagers were more used to pushing their changes directly, the more experienced packagers could still be using this this alternative workflow to trigger tests on demand on their changes and get feedback early and fast. Also, this system allows contributors to test dependencies together, as I said before. So before they are published, so you don't have to merge them, to build them, and potentially break everything because you introduced a broken package in your in a rawhide, for example. And that's a huge gain of time. And also, it's much better it's much nicer for the community because you don't break anything beforehand. If you break something, it's before, so that's okay. Nobody's impacted. Also, so the fact that most of the CI can be defined with a YAML file YAML files and jobs are Ansible playbooks. Should also lower the entry cost to contribute to the CI, which means that the CI could be everybody's business, which is ideal actually. Everybody should be concerned by the CI and make sure that it's working correctly. And finally, we believe that the workflow should allow for easier integration with the CI of other third parties, like other Fedora flavors and other Fedora vendors. Let's get a bit technical and talk quickly about how Zool and Pagure, so the code review system for Fedora packages, interact. So first, Pagure emits events on its event stream that Zool will listen to. And and on Zool you define some pipelines, and if those events match trigger conditions for a given pipeline on the repository for which the pull request was emitted, then you will trigger a set of jobs that are going to be executed by Zool. And on the other side, once those jobs are executed by Zool, Zool will emit poll the Pagure API to notify Pagure that the jobs are finished with the given result, failure, success, etc. So here is an example of a pipeline for Zool as it is defined. So basically, you will tell Zool which triggers to listen to. So we want to listen to a pull request event on Pagure, for example. And this pipeline name check is going to be triggered every time we have an open pull request or a change on the pull request, or if there's a comment on the pull request that matches this regular expression. So the word we check in the comment. We also want the pull request to be open, so we don't want to act on the code that is already merged. And then you can define what you want to do once the jobs are executed. So at the beginning of the jobs, you're going to notify Pagure to tell that the jobs are starting. And then on success and or failure, you will add a message called success or failure. So you might wonder where this file, which was a YAML file, as you could see, is living. So everything is hosted on Pagure.io. We have defined three repositories to set up this CI. So the first one, where this configuration lives, is Fedora Zool jobs config. So this repository defines which jobs and which pipelines are going to be executed for the diverse repositories. It also defines some jobs that need heightened security context from Zool. For example, when you publish with Koji, so you need extra security for that, and they are defined there. It's a special repository for this. Then you have two repositories that act as job libraries. So the first one is Zool distro jobs, which is a generic one that gives you some Ansible jobs and Ansible roles that are already defined in order to interact with Koji, with Copper, what else, with Mock, RPM inspect, and so on. And then Fedora Zool jobs is more inherits from those Zool distro jobs, but in a more specific context for Fedora. Also, we have computing resources that are hosted by our team, and we also provide maintenance of the images that are used and so on. So, Fabien, if you will.
So now let's talk about the jobs we want to implement such a flexible packager workflow. So first, RPM scratch bin. This is a job that builds SRPM from the pull request content, then trigger a Koji scratch build, then retrieves the artifact from Koji. So the artifact are the RPMs and the build log. Secondly, the RPM build. This is a job that runs a regular Koji build. Then RPM linter and RPM inspect are jobs that run respectively the RPM lint and RPM inspect command. And finally, RPM test that run the embedded functional test, so the test.yaml playbook that is contained in this Git. So each jobs are meant to run at a specific phase of the pull request lifecycle. So that's why we wrote project template that can be seen as recipes that associate jobs to pipeline. So on the top right, you can see the build and lint project pipeline definition. And at the bottom, you can see how we associate a list of templates to a repository. So we wrote the following recipes. So the build template that in the check pipeline will run the Koji Scratch build, then retrieve the artifact and expose the artifact to the child jobs. Then the lint template that will run the linter jobs, so rpm lint and rpm inspect, by using as a context the rpm built by the parent jobs. So you can notice the use of dependency, the dependencies keyword in the lint project pipeline definition. So it means that rpm scratch build is the parent jobs, and rpm inter and rpm inspect will weigh up. So they are child jobs, and they will wait for rpm scratch build to finish before they start. Then the test pipeline that run in the test template that run in the check pipeline, the functional test contained in the disgit, by using as a context the rpm built by the parent job. And finally, the publish template that through the gate and promote pipeline will merge the pull request and run the regular Koji job, Koji build. So now let's see the workflow we have built around the event pull request created, updated, or rechecked. So let's say a human packager create a pull request. Zool will get notified about this event, and due to that event, it will trigger the check pipeline. In the check pipeline, Zool will run the RPM scratch build that will perform the Koji scratch build. It will retrieve the artifact from Koji. Then, at the end of the job, Zool will store this artifact, so the RPMs, in a public storage. Because RPM linter, RPM inspect, and RPM test jobs have been defined with a dependency on RPM scratch build, Zool will start them in parallel. So each jobs will fetch the artifact from the public storage, and they will execute the rest of their tasks. For instance, RPM linter jobs will run the linter command, the RPM lint command on the RPM fetch from the store. Once it's done, Zool will store the result, and it will return to the pull request as a comment, a link to each job's result page. And it will also return a CI status, so success or failure in the pull request. The second part of the workflow is around the pull request approval and package publication. So let's say a packager wants to approve a pull request. So it will do that by adding the gated flag. So this is a tag on the pull request. And if the pull request CI status is already success, Zool will start the gate pipeline. In the gate pipeline, it will start the no-op job. This is a special job that do nothing but always success. And due to that success, Zool will merge the pull request automatically on behalf of the packager. Once the pull request is merged, Zool will get notified about this event, so it will receive the pull request merge event from Pagure, then it will start the promote pipeline. In the promote pipeline, Zool will run the Koji regular build to publish the package on Koji. Then, as usual, results are stored and returned back on the pull request. So now it's time to talk about dependencies. So how we manage RPM runtime and build dependencies. So dependencies between pull requests can be defined using the dependence keyword followed by the URL of the dependent pull request. So this keyword can appear multiple times in the pull request initial message to define multiple dependencies. And this is really nice in the packaging context. Dependencies between pull requests can be defined across different repositories. And it is even better because it works also across different platforms like Pagure and GitHub. So given a dependency graph, Zool prepare a job workspace with all dependent sources checkouted at the right version. So dependent, the source are ready to be used and validated. And if dependencies are exposed by the dependencies, Zool will expose dependencies to jobs as well. So thanks to this feature, we can write jobs able to handle dependencies easily. So for instance, we can write a job that handles RPM build dependencies. So it can be a job that injects dependent RPM in a mock build route to expose in the mock route the dependent RPM to have the build run as expected. And this is really awesome, for instance, when you need to validate the bump of a package that requires a bump on a dependent library, for instance, to build. And lastly, and regarding the runtime dependencies, the RPM test jobs already handle dependencies by preparing a Yum repository to make a Yum repository definition file to make the dependent RPM available during the jobs. So now time to do a quick demo. So I will create a pull request. So I already prepared a branch on my fork of the Python gear packaging. So I will create the pull request. So maybe it's going to be quite long, so we are going to move on something else. So this is a pull request that has been that have followed the full workflow, so from the proposal to the publication. So someone proposed a pull request, and we see that Zool runs the jobs and reports the job result as a comment on the pull request. It seems that everything passed except one job, but this is a job with the non-voting attribute, so it it does not count for the final result. So here it is a success, and we see that Zool reported a success as in the CI status. Well, it seems that the packager was okay with the pull request and the update. So to approve the pull request, it just added the tag gated to the pull request. And thanks to that, Zool catches that event, runs the gate pipeline, and merges the pull request on behalf of the packager. Great. So, okay, it's going to be a bit difficult to do the demo.
So, while Fabien works on this, all the bricks are there, believe us. It's just a network problem. We've tested the workflow 3 times in 3 different contexts. And this works here. Oh, maybe Fabien, you want to
tell me what you just want. Going to retry this.
The idea now is that we're able to people to be early adopters.
No, we can continue. So, I want to show also a bit the UI of Zool. So this is, I will be just able to show the result page, not the artifact. So so we see some information about the result. We have also access to the artifact that have been produced by the job. So this is the result of a run of RPM scratch build. So we can access, I don't know if you are familiar with ARA, but it provides nice report on Ansible playbook run. So out of the run of that job, we can click on the ARA report and show all the details. So this is really handy for debugging a jobs. You have also access to the repo artifact. So this is a repository, RPM repository that contain the package that have been built by the job. Okay, so Here the pull request has been unlead, but I won't be able to show more because the network is not great. But we see at least that Zool handle the event and is running the jobs at the moment. Okay, so that's great. So we see the RPM scratch build is running. We see the child jobs waiting for the result of the build. We have also access to the live console. I can quickly show so the use of dependencies. So let's say this pull request. So you can notice the usage of the dependence keyword followed by a dependent pull request. So this is a pull request initial message. So Zool handles that. And we can see this actually here. So Zool prepare an Ansible inventory for each job. And the Ansible inventory is exposed to jobs. So all jobs can use the variable defined in the inventory. And here you can see that we have this dependent pull request that has been added. So information of that dependent pull request has been added to the inventory. And if we click here.
So is it available in the workspace of the job? So you have the dependency there, and then you can do whatever you want.
You can see you have access to the repository data, the valid repository with the repo data and the RPM. And I don't think we have time to show that, but in that pull request, there is a dependency to a pull request that define, for the CI configuration that define a new jobs, and we can see that the job, by defining the dependencies, so this is a new job, mylinter, Zool have run it for that pull request. But this is only self-contained for that pull request. So we can see first it was a failure, so I had to fix my job, my other pull request, the dependent pull request, and then I saw that after a rechecked, the job passed. So it's really handy for CI operator, because now I'm confident as a CI operator that I can merge this pull request without breaking the CI, the rest of the CI. Okay.
So as we said, everything is ready. You can play with it yourself and try it for yourself and give us some feedback because we're really interested in knowing how you can do it. So we'll be at the Fedora CI meeting on Sunday. You can talk to us there. There's everything to explain how to do it on the wiki. And you can reach us as well. And we will take questions very quickly then. So please.
I just want to say this looks fantastic, so great job on the tool.
Thank you.
It's the hell out of James. Second question. Are you currently or do you plan to publish results on ResultsDB and publish the messages on your messaging for these results?
Yes, it's completely possible because, and even in a nice way with a Zool job. So.
Because if you do that, you can get a lot more integration. Yeah.
Test job, last job after all the linters, reads the tests YAML in the test folder. Is the current thing I have there and I run it on Jenkins and it's not always working? Is it compatible? Could I just keep running it at both places? Is it the same thing that just works?
And also, no relation, but we have stickers, so come down to us. It's in parallel, you can play with it, and if you like it, we can promote it something, but it's in parallel, it doesn't block anything. You don't even have to use it.
All information are in the project wiki page, so you have the link.
But you should use it. And again, we have stickers, so come talk to us. So yeah, we'll be there on Sunday, after this, so just catch us in the corridors.